Madam President, I want to speak a minute for just 4.5 minutes, I guess, about the natural disasters that have been confronting our nation. And in particular, in Texas, where the state has had about 3.5 million acres of land burned, and many people now find themselves literally homeless as a result of fires that many of my colleagues have seen on TV or watched on the internet, but they frankly don't capture the scale of the devastation. Just to give you an idea of the scope of this natural disaster, so far in 2011, more than 18,000 wildfires have been reported in the state. As I mentioned, it's burned an area roughly the size of Connecticut. That's nearly 2,900 structures have been lost, and unfortunately, there's also been a loss of life in these fires, as well as 5,000 Texans now been evacuated from their homes. And unfortunately, these fires have been a feature of life in parts of Texas for most of the year because we are in the middle of a historic drought where, because of La Nina, the weather pattern, we have an abnormally dry year, and indeed it's caused more than $5 billion of agricultural losses alone as a result of that drought. I've not only seen some of the devastation myself before I left Austin, but I've also talked to a number of people on the ground who are well informed. Representative Tim Kleinschmidt, who represents the Texas district east of Austin in sort of the Bastrop area, told me that as many as 1,000 people have been evacuated from his homes in that area and have been living in shelters since Sunday. Water and electricity are also down in many areas, and the wind has unfortunately swept the fire into areas and now is only about 30% contained. I've also talked to some of our other local leaders, our county judges, like Grimes County Judge Betty Shiflett, who told me what, while they have no unmet needs right now, they are very concerned about the threat to life and property and are working as hard as they can to contain the fires. I've also talked to our outstanding chief of the Texas Department of Emergency Management and the director of the Texas Forest Service, who tells me that as many as 2,000 Americans from places other than Texas have come to the state to help fight these fires and help protect property and life. We've had a good federal response to one extent, and that is the U.S. Forest Service has provided planes, bulldozers, and other equipment. Unfortunately, we have seen the White House so far not extend the disaster declaration beyond the original 52 counties approved for FEMA assistance on May the 3rd, or I should say that assistance ran out on May the 3rd more than 4 months ago. Suffice it to say that the disaster declaration should be extended to cover the rest of the state, at least 200 more Texas counties that need federal assistance. I'm informed from the reading the newspaper that President Obama reached out to Governor Perry yesterday to extend his condolences, but frankly, more than condolences, what we need are the resources to help fight these fires, to deal with the disaster, and to help get people back in their homes as soon as possible. I would just say that in conclusion, Madam President, that the majority leader has raised the question of whether disaster relief should be paid for or whether it should be borrowed money. I come down on the side of believing that we can't keep borrowing money we don't have. That's what the American people keep telling us. That's what the last election was all about. That's what the financial markets are telling us. And I believe that the American people believe that we have plenty of money in the federal government for Congress to do its job by setting priorities and funding those priorities. And I believe that emergency assistance to the people who've been hit hardest by these natural disasters are one of those priorities. We should fund it instead of funding wasteful spending and duplicative programs and engaging in failed Keynesian stimulus schemes. So, Madam President, with that, I yield the floor.